Welcome back for week 3 of April, and how, you know, we've been talking about Ruth and commitment. And today we're going to focus specifically on what is humility and how do I stay humble? How do I practice humility in my own life? And so again, I am just a mom, wife, psychologist, God lover, trying to do the next right thing and trying to please the Lord. And so today I want you to join me in talking about humility. And we're going to be focusing on verse, on Matthew verse 23, chapter 23, verse 12. And it states, "For whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and whoever humbles himself will be exalted." So what we see really in this Bible verse is that we must be humble, and we must, you know, not put ourselves higher than we are. And, you know, a lot of people think that when people hold high positions, or they are, you know, the boss, or they have kind of climbed the corporate ladder, or positions in church or work or career, that, you know, we kind of can walk around however we want. But really, you know, in order to effectively hold those high positions, you need humility. You need to be able to understand others. You need to be able to empathize with others. And so being an effective leader and being an effective wife and mom and career woman really takes us being humble, you know. And humility does not mean that we don't, you know, enjoy success or enjoy good things or nice things. You know, it just means that we know who we're giving credit to for these things, that these things don't come from us, they come from God. And so exalting our own selves makes it really hard to stay committed to God's will. When we think it's all about us, when we think that we've done these things on our own, instead of giving credit to whom credit is due, it becomes really difficult to stay level-headed, to stay committed to God's purpose, and to stay on track with God's will for your life. And so this week, I'm really going to ask you guys to think about your testimony receipt list. Like, what things has God done for you that you know deep inside that you cannot have done for yourself, that God must have really put his hand in? And keep that list close and near, you know, like, remind yourself constantly that these things you've achieved and done are because of God's will and grace, and not necessarily by your own doing. And that's a simple way for us to stay humble, to check ourselves, and to really not get ahead of ourselves, not get too big-headed, all right? So I'm glad that you guys joined me this week. Stay tuned, press like, follow us, and I will see you guys next week.